Hi, I'm Dave. I'm a tour guide down here at the Titan Missile Museum in Sahuarita, Arizona. I was served in the Air Force back in the 70s during the height of the Cold War in a Titan missile silo just like this. So I'm going to show you a couple things. On this video, we're out here on level 2 of the silo itself. This is the launch duct. It's a separate building within the silo. It's 146 feet tall. This is where the missile sits. We're looking at the second stage of the Titan II missile. Right now, this is as close as you can get to one of these things. It's the only place on Earth you can see a liquid fuel rocket back in its natural habitat, back in the silo where it belongs. Now, this is the second stage up above us, the black part. That's the reentry vehicle. That's where the warhead would sit. Now, these platforms, these would normally be up. To launch, they'd have to be up, but we would come down twice a day, we would lower them down, and we'd come out here and check the missile. We would spend 4 hours checking everything here. Now, the missile right here, the color of it, it's an alloy of copper and aluminum. It was only ever produced once for the Titan missile program. It's unweldable. That's why it's all riveted together. It's only as thick as a dime right here. The thickest part of the missile is only as thick as a quarter. It's sort of like a can of soda. The fuel and the pressure inside is what holds this whole thing together. 103 feet tall. It's 10 feet in diameter. It weighs 330,000 pounds loaded with fuel. It has 430,000 pounds of thrust. That's equivalent to 2 747s at full throttle. Well, this is only a 26-foot diameter tube. If you've been to an airport, you know how loud that would be. That sound energy would break this missile apart. So the Air Force had to figure out how to launch a missile from a silo underground. So if you look on the walls here, all these weird-shaped gray panels, they're like about a foot thick, filled with spun fiberglass, sort of like what's in the muffler of your car. 1963, this was probably the world's biggest muffler. We also have a 100,000-gallon tank of water attached to the silo. When you turn those keys, it starts dumping water under those engines, 9,000 gallons a minute out of these four giant deluge nozzles. When you put fire and water together, you create steam. The steam, the energy it takes to create that steam, absorbs all the sound energy. And the Titan II was the first rocket that could be launched from inner tube in the ground like this. All right. Thank you for watching this video. We'll have more videos coming your way. Thank you for visiting today.